New Mexico's number one balloon fiesta team, Action 7 News, presents live coverage of the 1999 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascension. This morning's broadcast is brought to you by Garduño's. Come taste the enchantment at Garduño's by Isleta Gaming Palace, just 7 lucky minutes south on I-25, by the New Mexico Lottery, investing in New Mexico's education, and by Don Chalmers Ford, the official chase vehicle sponsor of the 99 Balloon Fiesta. Now, live from Balloon Fiesta Park, your hosts, Nelson Martinez and Diane Anderson.
Very, very good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. And enthusiasts, balloon enthusiasts, as Albuquerque celebrates ballooning 27 years in the history books, soon it'll be number 28. Buenos dias.
It looks like another great weekend. Last weekend was beautiful both days. The balloons went up. They had a box. There was not a problem with the winds. And it looks like it may be the same way for both weekend mass ascensions this go-round. So it's perfect ballooning weather.
Luckiest people in the world.
Yep.
In the world and on the world, by golly.
You know, they have the Balloon Fiesta in October here. The reason it has grown so big is because they love our weather.
Yeah.
And it's perfect for balloonists. It's cold and crisp in the morning, and that makes those hot air balloons pop right on up there. The drainage winds coming off the mountain create a box effect where they can go different directions according to what elevation they are. And that's why they have it here, and we love our falls in New Mexico.
And how autumn is priceless. This is definitely, we know, land of enchantment.
That's right.
That's for sure. You know, last night I was coming in to park the RV out here, and it's another world again here.
Mm-hmm. Little community out there, huh?
No kidding. It was so busy out here, and fireworks going over the Duke Stadium.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Albuquerque is a happening city. No kidding. New Mexico is a whole
right.
Really.
We've had a really good week for ballooning all in all. There was the event on Thursday night. The Glodio was winded out. There was too much wind for them to have it. So the pilots got together and voted and decided to try the Glodio again on Friday night instead of on Thursday night. Friday nights, usually they have what they call a special shapes ascension for the most part, but the Glodio is where they stay tethered and light up, and it looked a little iffy yesterday afternoon. It was pretty windy, but by the time they went up at dusk, they say it was beautiful. I mean, they didn't go up, but inflated at dusk, it was beautiful, perfect for the special shapes Glodio last night.
Very, very beautiful evening. I'm sure many memories were made last night.
Mm-hmm. And there's another chance. There's another Glodio tonight, and it'll be followed by fireworks. I think it starts at 6 o'clock, something like that, tonight. And then, of course, the final mass ascension tomorrow morning at 7.
And, of course, we say good morning on behalf of an enormous staff from KOAT here. They all come out here bright and early in the morning and even stay the night and fix up, hook up the enormous amount of equipment to take that it takes to get
you
this
know,
broadcast.
It does. Almost everyone at KOAT is involved in the Balloon Fiesta coverage because it is a big event to us each year. We have a camera over here on the bluff, which is that big mound of dirt that's just to the east of the balloon field, and you get a really good perspective from there. We have two cherry pickers right here at our site, which is about midway down Concession Row, and you get good shots from there. We have
What's
Sky
a
7
cherry
up,
picker?
A cherry picker. Well, I don't know what else would you call that.
You can use that to pick cherries and pears.
But
and
it is kind of weird that they call it that because I don't see too many. Cherry trees aren't that big, but anyway.
Maybe we'll get a shot of it later and we'll show you how neat those things are. They extend way up in the air, so it gives us quite an aerial view as opposed to our balloon and Sky 7, speaking of which.
Sky 7, right now you can take a look at the traffic going into Balloon Fiesta Park from both directions, and I saw a shot just a little bit earlier, and it just looked like one light, stream of light in both directions because there's so many cars. We did hear Mike Sims talking earlier about an accident, a fatal accident north of Albuquerque, someone coming down from Santa Fe. I don't know if they were coming to the Balloon Fiesta or not, but that did create some traffic problems to the north of Albuquerque this morning. And I'm sure we'll hear more about that because Mike is another one of our crew members who's out covering the Balloon Fiesta this morning. And Rosalinda, we just got people everywhere. Joe Diaz will be out on the field, Tom Rutherford out on the field. So if you are at home, kicked back with a cup of coffee, we've got you covered every direction except for the real thing.
Yeah, Daniel, maybe you can swing over and get a shot of our executive producer, who is Dave Sebastian down here. He's right by the gate there, Daniel.
He's walking away
he's
to
walking
go check
away,
out something.
Go get coffee, no doubt. But anyway, he's out here, like I say, a lot of folks from our home KOAT are out here making sure the coverage is ever so exciting and beautiful. It really, how many adjectives? Charlie Gibson from Good Morning America was out here several years ago, uh-huh. you may remember, and as he stood here on the desk, he said, you know, I've run out of adjectives to describe this beautiful, beautiful celebration of color.
Well, the Mass Ascension is already gearing up at this point. There are balloons on both the north and the south ends of the field, which are cold inflating, and then they'll pop up before long and start to take off. Since we've been in this new field about 4 years now, there's the balloons carrying the flags. They are already taking off, so that's a good sign that the others will follow right behind them. But since we've been on this new field about 4 years, it's amazing how quickly the balloons go up because there's so much more room and they can start from both ends and work toward the middle, and before you know it, they've lifted off.
There's a young fellow here that represents many young fellows and girls and boys that come out here at all ages. You know, what an impression this makes on a child, you know, the celebration, the fun of it all. You know, it's just quite an experience for him, and I think that helps develop that character that is so very important in today's world. You know, the groups of kids out there, the majority of them are, you know, they're pretty good kids, come from good families, and even those that come from at-risk families, they're doing fabulous. The ones we hear about, of course, are the ones that go astray, if you will. But bring them out here, and look how exciting this can be on that impressionable mind.
Look at that Sky 7 shot showing the balloons cold inflated line on their sides along the different rows out at the Fiesta grounds. Before you know it, they'll all be up in the sky.
Aren't we lucky, really? We just talked about the wind factor here that just seems to cooperate so nicely the majority of the time.
It's felt pretty brisk and cold out here this morning. I think some people have said it's a little bit colder this weekend than last. It certainly felt like it anyway. You were speaking of good kids. The Cibola High School Band was the band that showed up early this morning to get out and play the national anthem as those first two balloons took off with the flags. And that's a lot of work. Those parents have to help the kids get all loaded up onto the bus and out here. I know Joe Diaz's son was one of the kids playing in the Cibola band. Each different Mass Ascension day, we're represented by a couple of high school bands out here.
That's quite a feat in itself. These young folks have to get up so early to get warmed up. You know, you just can't pop in there and play a trumpet with cold lips. Gotta practice, warm up, etc.
More shots of the balloon field from Sky 7.
Our New Mexico balloon laying in wake. Is that? No, that's not right. Well, it's kind of dead right now, but it's coming to life. The park is coming to life. People are pouring in from every direction, as always, and that's what makes this fiesta such a success, people.
We'll be going back out to check the traffic. If you haven't left home yet, we'll let you know whether or not it's worth even giving it a try at this point. It doesn't look like the crowds are too huge. I mean, they are big, but there's still room for standing room around out on the field. But you might have to fight quite a bit of traffic to get out here.
And we've got the facts. We've got books. We've got information right here on our desk. We can tell you who's where and from where. And Hans Peter Lausmann, Germany. Here's another pilot, Jennifer Lowndes or something like that, from Alberta, Canada. Yolanda something, Hajovic from Poland. First place winner, she is flying today in, what is the name of her ship, if you will? I can't find it on here, but anyway, we've got just amazing. There's how many people are
Tony
from
the Tiger.
Brussels. People
the
from
Tony
Brussels.
The Tiger balloon. We have about 800, almost 900 balloons. 898, I believe, was the predicted amount for this balloon fiesta. It's grown so much through the years. Back in 1972, it started out with only 13 balloons, but that got everybody's attention, and the next year it grew up to 138. And then over the years, by the time it got up to the mid-80s, there was around 400 to 500 balloons coming in. And then you get into the 90s, we started out with around 600, about 650 by 1994, and then we're all the way up to nearly 900 balloons here in 1999. There's a look at I-25 from Sky 7 showing the traffic streaming into Balloon Fiesta Park. I've been out here, of course I've come out really early. I think we've left the house at about 5 most mornings, but I haven't had any trouble in getting into Balloon Fiesta Park this year at all.
I haven't either.
Well, you've been sleeping, what,
actually,
a few feet away.
I woke up this morning and I was out of the, I woke up at 6, I guess, and 6:30 I was out of the RV there, and just a nice brisk walk over here, mm-hmm. and it's wonderful. I'm really enjoying this.
There are a lot of people who come in from all over the United States and park their RVs. In fact, you'll usually, a couple of weeks before Balloon Fiesta, you'll see the RVs already starting to park so that they get a really good spot. They get the closest they can get to the park. How far away is it if you're
the park?
Walking?
It took me about 12 minutes.
Oh.
Yeah, through the people, and already at 6:30 in the morning, it's getting pretty thick out here.
Mm-hmm.
Next thing is traffic lights, Will Nate. But you know, I was at Old Town yesterday. I've heard in our news broadcast that the influx of people in this town is just amazing. A lot of money being spent.
Right.
I happened to be on an errand to Old Town yesterday. And they were there. The stores were packed.
They
and
love that,
a lady
don't
over at Roadrunner place, Elizabeth Cook, was saying she has never seen such a good business thing here in the last Balloon Fiesta. Last year was like 50% off, I think she said, but this year it's just booming.
That's great. Well, you know, there have been a lot of events during the week other than shopping that these pilots and their crews took part in, and I bet Tom Rutherford can bring us up to speed on a lot of those. He's out on the balloon field this morning. Good morning, Tom.
Well, he's out there and he's talking. I see him on our other monitor. Let's see.
Good morning. Hey,
turn on the mic.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We are out here with the Southwest Airlines chase truck team. It has been a great week at Balloon Fiesta, although the winds haven't cooperated much during the week. But the flights that have been held have been spectacular. As you mentioned, the balloon, the special shaped Glodio, got postponed tonight, but last night turned out to be the perfect night for the special shaped balloons to glow. We gave away a pickup truck out here yesterday morning. Steve Lombardi from near Houston, Texas, flew his balloon from a mile away from the field and came in and grabbed the keys to a brand new Ford pickup truck from atop a pole in the middle of the field. Up until Friday morning's flight, only 10 balloons had scored in any of the competition. So yesterday morning was a critical day for the competitors. Now, part of ballooning is having all the equipment that goes with it, and the chase trucks are part of that. But I had never seen a chase truck quite this extraordinary. And so I'm here with Terry Eisenbart and Denise Jones. And Denise gets to drive this big truck. Now, this is like it's called a Texas Stagecoach, right?
Yes, it's made by Freightliner, and it's just it's called a medium-duty hauler, just like some of the ones that you'll see driving the Coors trucks or the Coca-Cola bottling.
Can we look inside? So this is the cab of the truck. It's you know, you could be on the road for a while with this thing, and then with a VCR monitor in there and all sorts of compasses and equipment and radios, and then room in the back seat for about 8 or 10 people. And then here in the side, behind the Southwest Airlines door number 3, this is where the balloon lives when it's on the road. The balloon, the gondola and envelope get packed in here, and then the equipment is on the back, and there's a crane here that lifts the balloon out of that and turns it around and deposits it on the floor or on the ground. And then here's the Southwest Airline balloon inflating. And can we honk the horn before we leave?
Sure.
And so Terry, this is Southwest Airlines' latest edition, but you really carry passengers in something more, a little more efficient than this, don't you?
Oh yes, we do. We've got them up in those 737s, and we've got the new 700s out there, which are bigger and better than ever.
1,200,000 people, I think, come and go from Albuquerque on Southwest Airlines every year.
That's correct, and I would swear half of them are here during the Balloon Fiesta.
I bet they are. Well, so we're at the Southwest Airlines balloon, and it's inflating now. Pilot Bill Jones is at the controls, but we're getting ready to get into this chase truck and go after them. And when we do, to help get the crowds out of the way. It's part of the fun at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We're here with a Southwest Airlines balloon.
All right, thank you, Tom.
Boop, boop. Well, anyway.
And then they'll move out of the way for that one.
No kidding.
We're going to go to a break, and we'll be right back with more of our live coverage from the Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta, so don't go away.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to live continuing coverage of the 1999 Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. I'm Mike Sims, live in Sky 7, along with Chief Photographer Randy Peterson and Pilot Jeff Martin. Let's take a look down at the field as the first wave of the balloons come alive and take off into the skies over Albuquerque. Another beautiful flying day, but a world-class ballooning event means world-class traffic tie-ups. Many people are still out on the roadways trying to get into Balloon Fiesta Park. This is a live shot from Interstate 25 headed northbound at the tramway exit, and as you can see, many people are still backed up bumper to bumper waiting to get inside the park. Traffic all morning long has been backed up. In fact, coming down from the foothills on tramway has been backed up. Over off of Alameda, coming in from the west side, was pretty thick. And again, as we've been reporting all morning long, unfortunately, there was a fatal accident on Interstate 25 southbound coming out of Santa Fe. Actually, it was closer to Bernalillo, and we understand someone crossed the median and ended up in a terrible accident. There's been one fatal accident. So if you are out on the roadways or plan to come out tomorrow, be sure to be extra careful. Let's go back down to Diana Nelson on the balloon field.
Thank you, Mike.
Thanks, Mike. Beautiful shots of from Sky 7 this morning. What is that?
That is the mascot that
Southwest Airlines.
Yeah, we were just talking
about
that.
You can see that little airplane.
Isn't that clever?
One of the things that you'll see walking around out here on the grounds. There are a lot of things for the kids to see. I think it's a good opportunity for businesses. Corporations have really learned to take advantage of all the different advertising possibilities at Balloon Fiesta.
When I make it in the music world, I'm going to get a balloon resembling a group of mariachis flowing out there. Wouldn't that be cool?
That would be really cool.
Hey.
We'll watch for that.
So a big part of the Southwest.
2001, two, maybe?
Perhaps.
Okay. All right. We'll hold you to it.
They say be careful for what you wish. You may
That's
get it.
That's true.
Yeah. Maybe we can get a shot of a beautiful card that we received in the mail, Diane and I. We'll show it to you in a little bit here. It always takes about 30 minutes for the reaction. So anyway, let's see here. This is a beautiful card. It's coming up, and we'll show it to you. Someone made it in their computer. Someone by the name of Mickey from Rio Rancho, offered the. Yeah, it's a balloon, and it's a pretty neat little card. It says, "Hi there, Nelson and Diane. Of course, I'm so glad to see you back.
Welcome blah, you blah, back. Blah, blah,
blah." Yeah, and they just took the time. Thank you, Mickey. Right? Let's see. Yeah, Mickey.
Rio Rancho fan.
Very creative.
It's amazing what you can do on a computer if you know how to work it.
Oh, no kidding.
Big if. You got to know what you're doing.
Yep.
Tom Rutherford's out on the field this morning. Let's go out and see what he's found now. Good morning, Tom.
From Raven, from Aerostar. So what's Raven Industries? Are they like still the parent?
Raven is still the parent of Aerostar, and Raven is a company that started modern hot air ballooning with the first flight in October of 1960. And Aerostar operates as a wholly owned subsidiary of Raven.
The U.S. Navy thought they could use hot air balloons to train blimp pilots and as a telemetry platform, so they called up Raven Industries in South Dakota, and they invented the hot air balloon, and Ed Yost flew it.
Ed Yost, the grandfather of modern ballooning, and he's living here in New Mexico now, retired. And, you know, we've got to credit a lot of this to Ed. This is where it all started.
He sure did. He started the sport, and then he was the director of championships for the first world championships in Albuquerque, and that's what really put us on the map. Now, tell me what's new since Ed first flew that balloon. What's different today about hot air ballooning?
Oh boy, so hard to know where to start, Tom. I think the fabrics we're using today, we expect to get 7, 8, 9, 10 years out of the fabrics we're using at the Fiesta. We've just introduced the new Zone 5 turbo burner, which is a higher output, many, many ergonomic features, quieter burners. What we've got today is just the state of the art, and it was almost more like the Model T's back 39 years ago.
One of the things I've talked about it here, the Balloon Fiesta is like the Indy 500 in that it creates a demand for better performance aircraft. People come here, want to compete, want to show off, so they want better performance. So companies like Aerostar come here, learn from the pilots what it is they want, and then go back and develop those new brighter fabrics or longer lasting fabrics or or higher burner systems. What's the newest special shape you've built?
The most recent one, well, we just did a new Energizer Bunny this past year, and we've got two or three on the drawing board, so we're not allowed to talk about. Of course, we've done the Sun and the Daisy and Snowman and Pumpkin, and many, many of the special shapes are flying here.
We'll probably see a lot of them this morning. Well, thanks to Raven Industries, who along with Ed Yost started the sport of modern hot air ballooning. And Ed and Raven have been part of the Balloon Fiesta since the beginning. I hope Ed is sort of watching from his place up near Taos, and we're glad you're out here from Aerostar. It's one of the fun things to do, stop by and learn from the manufacturers about the new ballooning equipment when you're here at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
All right, thank you, Tom.
Nice to see your face there this morning, Tom.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Tom, what can you tell us about? Did somebody win the key grab yesterday? Do you know?
Well, you know, the probably the most exciting event out here for spectators and certainly for the pilots is the key grab, where the balloons have to go a mile away in their trucks. They have to launch from at least a mile away and then try to fly over, and there are poles in the middle of the field. And one of the five poles has the keys to a new Ford truck on it, and there's a flashing light on the pole that has the keys. But they keep changing which pole it is. Before they were able to change it, maybe in the first 20 or 30 balloons that came by yesterday, Steve Lombardi flew over the field. Now, the normal launch site is an area just exactly 1 mile from here, just the other side of Tramway Boulevard. And early, the wind looked like it would take you from there right into the field. But just about time for launch, the wind shifted. So 100 or so balloons who were in that field ended up traveling off to the east of the field. Some of the other pilots, though, had gone farther north, more than a mile away, and had a little more time to adjust. Steve Lombardi was one of those, flew over the field at just the right altitude and just the right spot and grabbed the keys to a new Ford pickup truck. The key grab started here a long time ago, and Jim DiLorenzo was one of the guys who made sure it happened every year. He was at Quality Pontiac, and he worked with the Balloon Fiesta for years. Jim died this year in an accident, and so we saluted his memory on the opening Sunday of Balloon Fiesta, and we missed Jim DiLorenzo out here and expressed our sympathy as the balloon community to his wife Emily and his family. But the key grab continues, and Steve Lombardi, who by the way has won a car here in a key grab once before, is driving back to Houston, Texas in a brand new Ford pickup truck this year.
That makes it worthwhile. Thank you, Tom.
Hey, Tom, the gas balloon, the Bennett race. Gordon Bennett race, the team from Belgium, I believe.
Well, I want to tell you a wonderful story.
All right.
The Gordon Bennett race started in 1906. Gordon Bennett started it. He was a big newspaper publisher. He funded Stanley's trip to find Livingston because he liked to have extraordinary stories. And he started this balloon competition. It went for a few years. It stopped because of World War I. And then it continued again in 1937. The Belgian team won the Gordon Bennett Cup again. They went to defend their title in 1938. The race was held in Belgium. The winner was from Poland. So in 1939, the race was to be held in Poland. A week before the race started, the German army marched in and captured Poland, took it over, and World War II started. And so the Gordon Bennett Cup didn't happen again for a long time. And Belgium suffered a great deal from the war and never got back into the race until this year. And two young pilots came from Belgium. They had named their balloon after the balloon that won in 1937. And they were the least experienced of all the pilots in the race, but they had the most spirit and they won the race. Now, if you were a young man growing up in Belgium and you were thinking about coming to America as a child, think of the places you'd think of. Maybe you'd want to go to Disneyland. Well, these guys ended up 900 miles from here in Tupelo, Mississippi, the birthplace of Elvis Presley. So I think they're the envy of all the folks back home, and certainly the envy of the other 19 balloon teams who didn't fare as well, and we'll crown them and present them the Gordon Bennett Cup tonight at a special awards ceremony at the Crown Plaza Pyramid Hotel.
That's a great story, Tom.
No
Thanks
kidding.
For sharing that.
It was so fun, and they're so cute, and you know, and they just had so much enthusiasm, and everybody is so very proud of them.
Tom is, well, we remind the folks that Tom Rutherford, of course, has been with ballooning since its inception.
He's a wealth of information, and we're really glad to have him as part of our team every year.
He's also a Hall of Famer, the Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta Hall of Fame. He was inducted in 1983.
All right, let's go back out on the field again. Joe Diaz is out there this morning. Good morning, Joe.
Yeah, this is the part of the job that I love. Is when you're, you know, it's kind of cold out here on the balloon field, and you get underneath one of these burners here, look at that, and it warms up. I took my gloves off. But we're in one of the more popular shapes. We're with the Tony the Tiger balloon, and with me is Gary. Gary, why don't you introduce yourself and where you're from?
Gary Moore from Lake Havasu City, Arizona.
So what's it like flying?
It is the most popular balloon.
Yeah.
Let me correct you just a little bit.
But you know, there's always a trail of kids following you, isn't there?
Absolutely. This is the children's favorite for sure. Last night at the Glow, we must have gave out 1,000 stickers to kids all over the place. We have a good time with it.
Now, you like to come out here every year and fly the balloon?
Absolutely. This is our Super Bowl.
Yeah. Okay, so who do you have flying with you today?
Well, we have Rick Crossman from Subaru, who is supplying the automobile, the Subaru Outback, for first place in the competition. That'll be given away today at the awards show at noon.
Now, why don't you tell me a little bit how you win that competition?
The balloon races aren't really who gets there first, they're accuracy contests. There's the X's out either away from the field or on the field. You have to fly to the X, throw a marker. They measure from the center of the X and they accumulate points that way.
Boy, and the winner of that's going to get a car, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah, tell me about the flying conditions today.
These are the ideal conditions. This is what people come to Albuquerque, why they come to Albuquerque to fly. Okay. We have the box winds working above us. This is why we are here.
This is fantastic. Oh, wait, I forgot to ask you. What's it like flying the International Balloon Fiesta?
It's great!
And they did that without any prompting from me. Let's talk to the crowd over here. What do you think about the Balloon Fiesta here, buddy? Where are you from?
Albuquerque.
Pretty excited about being here?
Yeah.
Yeah, what about you? Where are you from?
Canyon, Texas.
You came all the way from Texas, huh? How long are you going to stay in town here?
Until tomorrow.
Okay, well, wave at the camera. All right. Yeah. Well, that's it from the midfield of the blue. Oh, wait a second. What are they doing here? Are you getting ready to go, Gary, or what?
We're getting close. As soon as we get a launch director, okay. We're ready to go.
Okay. I guess the deal is that the balloons over here have to lift off, and then the zebras will come over here and give us a good to go. So I think we're still a little bit before we lift off from the balloon field, but we'll throw it back to the broadcast booth right now.
All right, thank you, Joe.
The broadcast booth. That must be us.
Yeah, I guess so. You know, when Joe Diaz's son, Steven, was in the Cibola band this morning I guess they do the national anthem and a few other things, and they brought us by some cookies. I think they're having a bake sale out there, the Cibola band, to help support them, so... Nice orange icing, just in honor of October, I guess.
Halloween.
Looks like some good stuff. So if you hear us chomping when we come back from this break, you'll know why.
Yeah, there they are. Look at those yummy cookies. And, you know, anything goes for breakfast around here because it's balloon fiesta,
you've been up
you know?
A while. It's time for a cookie, right? Let's go to a break. We'll be back with more in just a moment. We are back live, and what a beautiful shot of the Rio Grande Valley with all those balloons spread out everywhere from our Sky 7.
And you were saying earlier that people from all over the world come, but you know, they're all important, but I think it takes a special effort for folks around New Mexico to come and see us. And I was just talking to Tip and Mary Cowan from Silver City. They were just here a minute ago, and we're saying hello to them out here, and they're part of the excitement. Tip and Mary Cowan from Silver City, nice to see you out here.
The sun is starting to come up over the mountains this morning and light up these balloons where you can really see their full color as they float along. The box looks as if it's working just fine. Some of those balloons are heading out pretty fast to the south, so maybe they're catching a little bit of wind.
And then they go up a little higher and it's a different story.
Yeah, they're just kind of standing still once they go up higher.
That's got to be fun if you've never ridden in a balloon. It's kind of interesting, you know, no noise other than occasional burner going.
Well, when you, I don't know what I expected, but when I first went up in a balloon, I thought I was going to be tossed about in the wind.
Right.
Well, I wasn't thinking that we are in the wind. So you're just sitting very peacefully floating along, not even feeling the wind at all.
Until you land.
Exactly.
And then they say, the pilot says, brace yourself.
That's right. And I've only been up twice, but my second one, I went up with my husband, gosh, quite a few years ago, and I don't know that he'll ever go back up. We had a rough landing. We sort of dragged the basket for a while, and those are some things that we've reported on this week. We've had a few rough landings, especially early in the week.
In
a
Oklahoma.
Lot of that due to the winds.
Oh, what was it?
It was a gas balloon
accident in Oklahoma.
In Oklahoma as well. Also a real hard landing. But this morning, so far, we really haven't had any landings. Everybody's still on their way up. The first wave is heading toward the middle of the field now. And then they'll gear back up and go up with the second wave of balloons.
There's the pig is waking up this morning.
Miss Penny. Who's representing Norwest Bank this year instead of...
Which is now
Wells Fargo this year instead of Norwest, because they just made the big switch this last week or so.
Right.
There's Champagne.
Corbel.
You can tell I don't drink too much.
Corbel.
But anyway, one of the champagne bottles. Miss Penny is usually followed by a little buck, who is her baby brother balloon. He'll be going up in the same spot, just in the second wave instead of the first. They're very good brother and sister. They take turns going first.
It's interesting to know how many people are out here for the very first time. You see people just looking in awe. And I saw someone this morning as the Dawn Patrol and all that, and they're staring at it as if it were their first time. And I said, is this your first time? Oh, no, we've been here coming.
Right. People who've been here many, many years still just take it all in as if it was their first adventure.
Uh-huh. Pilots, again, from all over the world, Belgium, Canada, England, Germany, of course, Poland, Spain, and Sweden, Switzerland. It's pretty cool. Mexico, we have a few balloons out here. Japan.
I've even seen one of the Japanese balloons. I'm trying to remember what it was.
Osaka.
Yeah.
I think Osaka.
There goes Tony the Tiger, and I love Virginia. Virginia is for lovers. That we see that balloon just about every year. It's a great way for different states to promote tourism. Also, Canada always takes advantage of that and brings the maple leaf and usually the Mountie. But of course, this year the Mountie got his backside singed over in Texas, and he didn't make it to our balloon fiesta, but he'll be back next year. There's the KOAT balloon. We'll be having a camera going up in one of the balloons a little bit later.
This certainly is, this balloon fiesta, as it's been written, that it is the city's pride, the sport of ballooning, which numbers among its greatest achievers, many citizens of Albuquerque. I mentioned them from all over the world, but Albuquerque too. You know, pilots take a lot of pride in being part of this fiesta. It, as they say, adds additional weight to the city's claim to be the balloon capital of the world.
Magellan T. Bear is one of the new balloons this year, and he is right behind us, about ready to take off. He is actually, they call him Magellan II because he is a replica of a balloon that's in the Smithsonian now, called Magellan T. Bear. Magellan has taken a lot of trips around the world. He started out as just a little stuffed bear created back in 1993 by a couple of Colorado teachers.
He was an 18-inch stuffed bear.
Mm-hmm. And they were using them as an instructional tool for elementary students. And he actually kind of made some trips all over the place. He traveled to 7 continents. He slept in the Lincoln bedroom at the White House. He visited the bottom of the ocean in a nuclear submarine and traveled around the world not once, but 129 times with the crew of the Discovery Space Shuttle. He has really had an exciting time for a little stuffed bear, and that big balloon is just to remind us of Magellan T. Bear. That's Magellan II. And he is representing the RE-MAX group at this point, and he's carrying a little RE-MAX balloon with him. Let's go out live now to Rosalinda Roman. Good morning, Rosalinda.
Oh, I think we're here.
Yes, you are.
All right.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you guys?
Well, not bad, and it looks like traffic is going smoothly.
Yeah, traffic is going smoothly, but I tell you what, a lot of people don't even want to mess with the traffic, and so we found a spot where people are gathering because they figured, why bother? So take a look behind me. You can see there's just a gorgeous view from this location. We're at the corner of Alameda and I-25. It is really a nice location. We found a lot of people who obviously are pros. They have done this before. Now, I met with a family. This is the Doherty family. I think I said that right, I hope. Daughtry. And you guys, have you done this before?
Yes, ma'am. We came down here last year after watching it on the news, Channel 7. They told us about
it. It's a good spot because you basically can see everything. You were telling me about the plan that you had when you came in this morning.
Right. We got the camera and the coffee, and we go inside and have a little breakfast, and then come out here and wait for the balloon to come on up.
So what do you think? Was it worth the view sitting here?
Oh, this has got to be a lot better than fighting with the traffic, and escape is easy, too.
And you all are from Albuquerque, right?
Right, yeah.
And you still love the Balloon Fiesta?
Oh, yeah. As you look at Craig. He's excited.
Little Craig over there, if you take a look over there, Craig is taking a look at the, he's in awe there. Hi, Craig. Say hi to everybody. Well, as you can see, lots of families here, very much enjoying the view. You can see, I don't know if you can see behind me, but the traffic was backed up, but now it is going smoothly along I-25 there in the distance. But there is quite a bit of a wait still, and we've seen it back up as far as here to Alameda. Most people are being directed to the tramway exit because apparently the Alameda parking lot is full. So if you are still heading down here and planning to get a parking spot, you're going to want to take the tramway exit. Reporting live from near Alameda, Rosalinda Roman, back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Rosalinda. I've noticed I live just to the east of Balloon Park, actually quite a ways up Alameda, and I was out taking a walk earlier this week, and there were some people who every day were out there with their folding chairs and their binoculars checking out each morning's mass ascension. We have a guest with us this morning, as we usually do, who, as they drop by our studios, our outside studios, to tell us what their part in the Balloon Fiesta is. Here's Nelson Martinez.
Thanks, Diane. Scott Griffith is with us this morning, amidst all this glare and pomp and circumstance, if you will. Scott Griffith is one of the sponsors, or is senior vice president of the operations for Motel 6. We'll leave the light on. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you, sir?
It's great. Great to be here.
Isn't it exciting? I mean, beautiful. I ask that to everybody, but you know, I'm looking for someone who says, "Nah, it's dull."
Oh no, no way.
I don't
Not
think
if they're
so.
Here, they can't say that.
So you have been a sponsor for how many years here?
This is second year now.
Welcome aboard, as the chamber would say, probably.
Right.
Yeah.
It's great to be here.
What? Where are you from originally?
Originally, I'm from Phoenix.
Phoenix,
yeah.
And you've been here 7 years, or how many years?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what's the deal with Motel 6? Where is the Motel 6 floating around in the sky?
It's in the second wave.
Oh, is
so
it really?
We're inflating right now.
What do you look
take
like?
Off. Oh, it's a big blue balloon.
Blue
We've
balloon.
We've got a big banner on it for Motel 6.
All right, that'll work.
Yeah.
All right, and anything else you want to kick in there?
Well, we're just proud to be here, and it's a great event, and it's great to see Albuquerque highlighted in the world press like this, and it's great for the whole state.
You bet.
We're glad to be here.
Will you're gonna do what now?
We're gonna leave the light on for
it. Scott Griffith, thank you very much.
All right, we're gonna go to a break, and we'll be back with more of our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park. So don't go away.
Back again with you for the final weekend of the, is it 48th, I want to make it older than that is. 28th annual Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. Hi there, good morning, how are you? Those things that light up at night, you know.
Right.
Those funny little things on the that they wear as a headset or headdress or whatever you want to call it. And the big tennis shoe that's like, there he is again. Morning.
Kind of hamming for the camera this morning.
Adorable.
There are kids everywhere out here, and you see them all bundled up, some of them in wagons, and some of them in backpacks, and some of them in strollers, and some of them with blankets all over them.
You know,
I don't blame them. It was a little chilly.
Well, it seems like, as you say, as soon as the sun comes over the Sandias, it feels like this cold air really drops on you. I feel a little more chill now than I did earlier.
That's usually the way it works, and I'm not sure why, because you'd think by this time of day it would be warmer, but I think it's those drainage winds that come down off the mountain which make the ballooning so good, but just make it chilly for us here on the ground.
Yep. Tom Rutherford is out there once again. Tom, give us some more info what you're so good at.
Well, thank you. I've been out looking around at the crews doing all the work here and looking for interesting outfits, and I found this Balloon Team Santa Fe. Can we see under it? Now, where do you see this outfit? Look at this. Santa Fe, New Mexican. Can you turn around? Now, where are you from?
We are from Germany, and the town is Neumünster, and the restaurant is in Kiel. And we have a balloon, and I help.
And you help?
Yeah.
And is this a New Mexican restaurant?
Yes, in Kiel.
And does it serve like tacos and enchiladas? Does it have sopapillas?
Yes.
Really?
Really.
Now, these three fellows just met on the airplane, is that right? Where are you from?
Flensburg, Germany.
And have you ever seen this many balloons before?
No, never.
Your pilot has been here before, is that correct?
7 times.
But this is the first time for you?
It's the first time for me, yes.
And where do you come from?
I come from North Germany, from Bad Segeberg. It is the first visit in Albuquerque for me. It's great, it's wonderful.
And do you fly balloons in Germany?
No, I fly not. I have started here in Albuquerque the first time. And today is my third driving with a balloon.
And so is this you don't usually do this. You're doing this very well.
I do it
like you did it before.
Yes. Many years ago, I was by flying in a flying club in Neumünster. From the owner from this balloon is the town. And there was a young man, I was flying there. But I have finished, and now I will hope it's my new hobby.
Very good for you. So these three men met on the airplane coming to Albuquerque, and they're now the crew of this balloon down here. Sort of rainbow shape. What's the name of the balloon?
Rheingas.
The Rheingas balloon. So some of our international visitors, welcome to New Mexico. We hope you have a great time. Willkommen. Guten Tag. Thank you. Dankeschön.
Dankeschön.
Thank you.
And my favorite word or salutation in German is Wie geht es Ihnen? Gut, danke, et mit Ihnen? Well, you know, that's it. But anyway, it's an international balloon fiesta, to say the least. You hear so many languages out here. French, that romantic language, as well as Spanish. The folks from Spain are out here with their Estamos aquí muy bonito que suave, or something like that. You know, those S's or the C's that they roll through the tongue. And, of course, our New Mexican language is out here. Orale, look at the pretty balloons. I love it. Diane, you've got the Mountie with you this morning.
I sure do. I sure do. I have a couple of representatives from the Canadian Royal Mounted Police. And, of course, we talked to the Tourism Commission last weekend. They told us a little bit about what happened to the big Mountie balloon, which is always one of our favorites. But let's tell everyone again, we're represented by an actual real Mountie instead of the balloon. Hi, what's your name?
Hi, my name is Constable Mark LeFave.
All right, thanks for coming by. You've been here before.
Yes, I had the honor of participating in your fiesta last year as well.
Oh, terrific, and you are?
My name is Chief Superintendent André Touin.
And this is your first balloon fiesta?
Yes, it is. I'm very impressed. This is quite exciting.
Do you travel a lot with the balloons, or is this something that you just do once in a while?
No, it's an exceptional circumstance where I've been given the honor and the privilege to come down and participate. So
well,
it's a real special treat for myself.
And you are out there with the maple leaf is what you brought along this time.
That's right. This is correct.
All right. Tell us again what happened to the Mountie and why he's not here, the Mountie balloon, and why he's not here this year.
The Mountie balloon was making an appearance at the Dallas State Fair because our musical ride equitation team is there performing for the month. And subsequent to the flight, the pilot had a brush fire set off, and because of the dryness and the fire that ensued, the heat caused a little bit of singeing to parts of the tail and legs. So we're going to have to assess the damage when we get it home and hopefully have it repaired for next year.
But you expect to have him in working shape again?
Well, we're hoping for the best. It's, I would say, like in the normal language that we have at the stable is at the vet right now.
I would say
and so. And they're looking at it there, and we hope that it's going to be back on its feet. The sooner the better, yeah, that's for sure.
Has the balloon been a good promotional tour, I mean a promotional tool for not only tourism but also for the Mounties?
It has. Everywhere I've gone, and here it's been the most asked question, obviously, since I've been here. Everybody has just, first of all, felt us so well, made us feel welcome, and has made us feel part of this because they all remember how wonderful the balloon presence was here last year.
I think it was actually voted favorite last year.
Exactly. Yeah.
Now, you brought along the maple leaf, though, so you guys have been out there.
Yes, we've been here for a couple of days now. Mm-hmm. And
you went up in the second wave this morning?
Yeah, yes, this is the maple leaf's going to be going up there pretty soon.
And earlier, I guess it was last Sunday, you guys took up the Dream Team, or the Dream Team was a group of kids, Make-A-Wish kids, who crewed for the Maple Leaf last weekend.
Yes, as a matter of fact, some of those young persons will be with us this morning, helping
us
out one more time.
All right, what a great thing to do. Well, thanks. You represent Canada well, and thanks for jumping by and talking to us this
morning.
Thanks
for having us.
All right, we'll look for you out on the field.
All pleasure. Super.
Thank you.
The Canadian Mountie. They look sharp. Do they stop? Do you patrol the streets and give tickets and all that in Canada? No, okay. It's another uniform. nonetheless, it looks pretty sharp. We've got a lot of things going on this weekend. Oh, down in Truth or Consequences. Don't forget, Geronimo Day is going on today, tomorrow. I'll be down there with Mariachi Los Galleros to kick off the fiesta. Well, not to kick it off, but to keep it going. And they have a lot of entertainment down there besides myself. I like those romantic mariachi songs. And the Galleros from El Paso will be there to join me at 2 o'clock. Hope you can join us down there. Truth or Consequences, Geronimo Days. Nice to see all these people out here. Cousins and cousins, I see. Let's go to Joe Diaz, who is out in the field. Mr. Meteorologist, the fine job you did this morning with the weather.
Well, that's right, Nelson and Diana. Just a fantastic day for flying here at the Balloon Fiesta. Let's kind of set it up right now. We had the first wave pretty much off in the air. And down here, we got the second wave getting ready to inflate. And, of course, there's something like nearly 900 balloons entered in this year's Fiesta. And, of course, this is a big day because a lot of these pilots will be leaving after the mass ascension today and drive. You know, they had about pilots from 42 states, so a lot of them will be getting back. So this is a great day for flying. And one thing I like about the Fiesta is that there's always a sense of community. It seems like every day they have some sort of marching band. And today at 7 o'clock in the morning, the Fiesta crowd was treated to the music from the Cibola High School Golden Regiment Marching Band. Right now, introduce yourselves. What's your name?
My name's Chad Wilson.
Now, what do you play?
I play tuba.
You play the big tuba. Now, yeah. Now those big tubas, when they march around, they're not called tubas. They're called what?
Sousaphones.
I didn't know that. I always called them tubas, but they're actually the marching tubas are not tubas. They're there you go, sousaphone. What about you? What's your name?
My name's Mandy Lenners, and I'm the color guard captain.
Oh, cool. Now, how is it performing to the crowd today?
Great, actually. We got a great response after we play. You know, it's great feeling.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, the sun's coming up over the Sandias and the big marching band and the great sounds that come out. And another neat thing that they do here at the Fiesta is that the bands that are allowed to come out and play, they're able to set up a little booth and sell some goodies for fundraising activities. And that's what you have here. Now, check this out. Look at this. The hot air ballooning game. Now, what's the story on this?
It's just basically a balloon game just in favor of the festival, and it's a hot air balloon racing game.
Now the neat thing is that I think about 10 years ago, this was sold in stores, and I think the price of this balloon game, hot air ballooning game, was like $29.95, but the maker of the game, he donated a whole bunch to the Cibola High School Marching Band, and you're doing it as a fundraiser, so you're selling these, not at $24.99, not at $29.99, but how much?
$5.
$5, can you believe that? So it's kind of like a Balloon Fiesta celebration there, and it goes to a good cause, the marching band. I saw you guys last night at the brand new stadium over in Rio Rancho. You sounded great, the band from Rio Rancho sounded great, and you had a late night, but you're up early, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, well, go out and enjoy yourself. And a lot of people like to do is they take a lot of pictures. You take a lot of pictures?
Yes.
Where are you from?
Albuquerque.
What's your favorite kind of picture you like to take?
Of the balloons.
Yeah, you know what I like to do? I like to get the people lined up and get the balloons in the background. And
right.
There's plenty of opportunity to do
there
that.
There certainly is.
Okay, well, enjoy yourself. Well, that's the story from the balloon field as that second wave getting ready to go up. And we'll try to hook up with one of these balloons and give you the feel and the excitement from
from another part of the field as you're at our next cut-in. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Joe. A balloon game for only $5, huh?
And there is a citizen that is just as happy as a lark.
His first balloon fiesta, wouldn't you say?
I would bet money if I were a betting man. And that is, what is that guy's name, that little bear?
He's here just about every year.
Yeah, he is. I'm trying to think of his name, but I'm having a senior moment. let's see if I can find him.
I think these balloons are so interesting. It's the Festo balloons, and they have one that looks like it is upside down. It is so cute. The gondola floats up in the air, the whole bit, and you actually can't see it, but the real gondola is up kind of inside the bottom of the balloon so that it looks like it's actually flying upside down. And they fly together. There's another pair kind of like that. It's Humpty Dumpty, and there's Humpty right side up and then Humpty falling off the wall, and
it's called
Off the Wall. Uh-huh. And it's really a cute pair of balloons as well.
From Missouri, yeah.
It's nice to see them do that. There it is. Look at it, the balloon.
Carol Jane Buckles is the pilot on that one, and Lindell Buckles.
I see some special shapes starting to inflate back behind us this morning. We're going to have Arabelle, the Creamland cow. She's starting to lift up her head right over. Looks like she's going to take a big bite of those chili ristras right in front of her. And it's about ready to inflate as well. And there'll be a dragon just to the north of them.
Wow, how did you do that,
Diane? I'm choreographing this, you know? I'm producing this morning. Not really. Thank goodness we have good producers who follow what we say.
No kidding. That's the deal. There's the dragon.
And what is that thing? So many different faces and characters out here.
Yep.
Ah, our producer says that's Hagar the Horrible.
Uh-huh.
With a nice smile, though.
Waking up in the city of Albuquerque.
I believe the first wave has already completely gone off, and now we're seeing the second wave start to go up from the north end of the field and the south end of the field as well.
They're moving at quite a clip just as they lift, and they're going directly south, and of course they are
going back up. The box is working, and kind of drifting very slowly back over our way.
Yeah.
We're going to go to a break, and we'll be back with more of our live coverage, so stick around. There is Arabelle. Inflating and about ready to take off as the second wave gets down her way. A lot of special shapes represented in this mass ascension this morning. That is the Hopper T Frog. It's one of the new balloons this year. All right, let's go back out to Rosalinda Roman. And she's got some people right along watching the balloons from outside so they don't have to fight the traffic. Good morning, Rosalinda.
Good morning, Diane. As you can see, we've got a really nice view out here. I don't know if you can see behind me, but there are nice shots of balloons here. And like you said, a lot of people just don't want to mess with the traffic this morning. Take a look over here. You can see there is quite a crowd here along Alameda and I-25. People just decided to pull up their lawn chairs. We're right next to the Burger King, so they've got breakfast handy right here. And people are really excited to be here. It's a nice way to see the balloons without actually having to sit in traffic all morning. You can see the view behind us. Now, it goes all the way down this way, too. If you take a look over here, there's families lined up all the way over here. And I'm going to put someone on the spot now. Lavinia? Sam. Lavinia Sam is here with her family, and I understand it's your first balloon fiesta.
Yes, it is. My very first time here, and it's really, really nice.
It's actually my first time, too. So are you getting that stomach bubbly butterfly feeling, excited to see the balloons?
Oh, yeah. This morning I got up, it was like, usually I'm not a morning person, but this morning I jumped out of bed and I had to meet my parents here. It was so awesome. And it's worth it.
A lot of people say it's kind of like Christmas morning, all the balloons going up and all the color and the excitement. Is it?
Oh, it is. It really, really is.
Excellent. And I understand your family traveled quite a way to come.
Oh, yeah. They traveled from Chinle, Arizona.
Excellent. And are they excited too?
As you can see, they all are.
No, I can see they're hiding back here. Now we'll put you guys on the spot. Well, thank you, and we are glad you're here. It's very exciting out here. Obviously, as exciting out here as it is back there in Balloon Fiesta Park. Lots to see wherever you are, and if you want to avoid the traffic, there are lots of options. We're going to toss it back to you there, Diane and Nelson, back at Balloon Fiesta Park.
All right, okay. Thank you. Rosalinda Roman. It's a little too early. My old thick tongue doesn't want to talk right this morning. Anyway, Nelson Martinez has a guest with him and a very colorful display.
Rosalinda just mentioned it's like Christmas morning, yeah. Especially if you get a balloon for a present.
That's right.
Or one of these beautiful posters. We have with us this morning Artiste Mark Pashan. Passan, right?
Passan, that's right.
And you're from England, are you?
Yeah, Northampton, England.
And how's my accent? Is that okay?
Dreadful.
Could I adopt if I moved to England?
I don't think so.
I'd be... it's always best just to be yourself, right?
Of course.
Tell me about your beautiful poster. You've got two of them here made into one. Last year's and this year's?
That's right. Yeah.
It's all right.
No, it's just...
Don't be nervous.
New Mexico is such a huge place. The sky is so big and full, and the landscape is so vast that I think it needed two posters to try and get that across.
There you go.
That's what I did.
So
this year's is called Illusion, and it's the sky version. And I've used a giant Zia as the centerpiece.
Right.
And if we can drop out last year's.
Okay, let's see. So it's attached.
So that's the ground view.
Wow.
Again with the petroglyphic Zia.
So those are all the special shapes.
Yeah, and then you get the full perspective from looking down on top of the balloons on last year's poster to looking up at the balloons on this year's poster.
Well, look at you. Very good.
Thank you very
much.
What
an artist you are. Now, how did you do this? Is it photographs?
No, it's painted. Each painting takes me about 150 hours to paint.
And
I use a paint called gouache, which is like a thick watercolor.
Uh-huh.
I did it the old-fashioned way.
And they're available here at the park?
They're available a minute from where we're standing, next to the post office near all the main official booths.
Next to the post office, okay, here in the line of booths.
That's right.
And there are about 100 vendors here, maybe more. So, but next to the broadcast booth here?
Literally just a stone throw from here.
KOAT's booth, and then you'll bound to find it, huh? What's the shop called?
It's the Wells Fargo Special Shape Rodeo Poster is the banner on
okay.
the front.
Sounds good. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Nice to be with you, and good luck on your poster. It looks marvelous.
Thank you very much.
What a nice souvenir. Back to you, Diane.
I'm sure that'll be a favorite with all the kids. Have to get some of those to hang up in their bedrooms.
Yeah.
Tom Rutherford's out in the field. Speaking of kids, there's kids all around out there, and he's just a big kid in the middle of them.
I feel like a kid. There's no doubt about it. And I'm with one of the kids. I guess you're not a kid anymore. I used to be in the legislature with his mom. This is Scott Appleman. Scott is the pilot of the Ocean Spray balloon, which you can sort of see behind us. His wife, Liz, is getting it inflated while he's over here taking all the credit.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Scott and Liz have a company called Rainbow Riders, and in addition to flying the Ocean Spray balloon, this year they are the official balloon ride concessions. Now, I say during the week on the tower that these are people taking their first balloon ride. Is that mostly what happens?
Yeah, probably 99% of the people, this is their first flight. We have several people that try to fly every year at Balloon Fiesta, and this year we've had fairly good weather in order to accommodate everybody.
How many people have taken that first ride at Fiesta so far this year?
This year alone, after this morning's flight, we will have flown over 1,500 passengers. And we've had a very, very great week. Safe is always number one with us, and having a lot of fun.
How much does it cost to go for a balloon ride?
What we have available right now are second hop flights for tomorrow at $175 per person. But the prices range up to $200, depending upon day and flight.
And you helped start the Balloon Glow. Linda Rutherford was the director of the Balloon Fiesta, the executive director, and she and we had been to Longview, Texas, and seen a Balloon Glow, but weren't sure it was the thing to do. And Linda came to you, and you got this started, didn't you?
Yeah, Linda was the first to get this thing going, and we had organized the event. Everybody said you couldn't do this, it wouldn't happen. And we definitely proved them wrong. Now with 300 plus balloons doing Balloon Glow, and there's another one tonight, so everybody should come on out and see that this evening, right around sunset.
Tonight's the Night Magic Glow, sponsored by Big Daddy's Barbecue, and then Air Touch Cellular presents fireworks right afterwards. So what time would you get out here today?
Oh, if you're out here by 5 or 5:30, you could come on out, have some nice dinner, enjoy a beautiful sunset, and see the balloons getting set up.
Be great. And if you want to go for a balloon ride tomorrow morning,
Feel free to call us at 293-0000.
This is one of the originators of the Balloon Glow and the Balloon Ride Concessionaire and the pilot of the Ocean Spray. I was getting Ocean Spray light cranberry juice for a while, but they don't have it anymore. Would you mention to them that I really want that light cranberry
I'll
juice?
I'll work on them. We all have to work on our fingers.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes. Oh, it's part of the fun at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
All right. Thank you, Tom. Boy, there are a lot of special shapes going up this morning. I just saw the hot dog lift off, the ballpark Frank, and there's a little silver bunny with the big, tall pink ears is always one of my favorites. He's out there, too. And little Buck is going to be going up in just a few minutes, and Arabelle and the Chili Ristra. And there's a big house. Kind of almost looks like a castle that I haven't seen before. I think that may be a new one this year.
The Hearst Castle, maybe.
Yeah. There's the ballpark Frank. Floating along, very tall, skinny balloon. These special shapes are huge. There's Humpty Dumpty. We saw the upside down Humpty Dumpty earlier. That's Humpty before he made the big fall.
Humpty Dumpty always reminds me of my grade school years, as it does you, I'm sure. And one of the sayings that, you know, growing up in northern New Mexico, we used to hear the pop goes the weasel. Well, we always thought it was papas con chorizo. Humpty
you
Dumpty, I don't
have
know
a
why.
Different perspective.
I don't know what the connection was, but anyway, all my life is papas con chorizo.
Okay. Let's go out on the field now where Joe Diaz is. Joe?
Okay, I guess we're, I was like, what's that balloon over there? You see that house over there? That's supposed to be the, what were you telling me that is?
Malcolm Forbes Chateau.
Okay, so that's what Malcolm Forbes lives in. There's the bunny rabbit over there. I don't think I've ever seen him before. At least I haven't seen him recently. And when we look back over here, we get the dragon getting ready to inflate. Now, we're broadcasting from the part of the field where the Canadian maple leaf is getting laid out over here. And I'll be talking with that pilot probably next time we join you. Of course, a lot of people come out here. And one thing they like to do is go to the concessions. And what do we have right here?
The Johnsonville Brats.
A Johnsonville Brat. I love these things. Now, remember, they're in that big old trailer. And how many of these things do you cook up a day?
Well, we can cook 750 at a time. And
750. Here, Russell, yeah. I want you to try one of these. Russell's my field producer, and I said I'd feed you if you'd work with me today. Take. Russell's trying the Johnsonville Brat. What do you think?
Yes, very good.
Don't you like talking on live TV with your mouth full?
Mm. Yeah.
You eat it. You eat it. Well, buddy, I already ate, man. So, I guess you started coming out here, what, a couple years ago?
Yeah, about 5 years ago.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, going strong. Cooking up Johnsonville Brats and Johnsonville Italian sausage today, so got plenty of them.
I love the smell of that as I walk by. And what do we have over here? We have pizza.
Pizza. Yeah, we've got a bus down the road here, the concession row. It's on the left-hand side. It's okay. New in the supermarket. It's great tasting pizza. It's got live yeast in it.
All right.
Yeah.
So it really doesn't taste like frozen pizza when you're done with it.
No, it tastes like carry out, exactly like carry out.
And another tradition that I'm coming to enjoy here at the Balloon Fiesta is the guitar guy.
Yes, the Earthlings.
Now, where are you from again, the guitar guy?
Well, in the boonies near Santa Fe.
Okay, buddy.
I live on a cattle ranch.
Now, do your guitar guy thing. See, you're a guitar guy doing his guitar guy thing. I don't think he ever plays the doggone thing. He just kind of dances around with it. Now, you're going to toss it up or what? Yeah, we're ready. Now, how do you like that? You don't get that on cable television. We're going to come back and talk with the Maple Leaf pilot in just a bit. We'll throw it back to Nelson and Diane.
Are you sure that guy wasn't breathing too much of that butane out there? Man.
People are having a good time out here this morning.
That's the name of the game.
That's Augie. You're seeing the very top of Augie's head. He's one of it. It looks like a big dragon, actually, starting to inflate. He's from California. Pilot.
I wonder if Mikasa Shukasa is out here today. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen it yet. That's a beautiful
one that looks like the old woman in the shoe,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah. And we've got the battery.
That's the Energizer Bunny, right?
Yeah, the Energizer Bunny.
I can't see the preview. You're hogging the preview.
I'm hogging it. We have a little special monitor down here hidden from all. And
look at
we get
that
to
great
see
close-up of those shades on the Energizer Bunny. A lot of special shapes represented this morning. There's
including
that house.
That
I said, I think the Forbes Chateau is what Joe said. That's not one that I have seen before,
mm-hmm.
and I no information about it, but it's a pretty cool looking balloon.
Quite large.
The Energizer Bunny is flown by Mel Hansen from House Springs, Missouri.
Just look at that.
Look at that big house taking
off.
I mean,
it is big. I don't know if you can see the perspective at home, but here it takes off. It takes up a few city blocks.
And there's, like I said, one of my favorites, that little silver bunny with the big pink ears going off right behind him. Another one that I think is really cool this year that I haven't seen yet is, I saw him last weekend, is Ducky. Bunnies, duckies, whatever. It's like a kid's toy box.
Meantime, past the, what is that that you serve with turkey, that Ocean Spray?
Ocean Spray, that's what Tom was talking about just a few minutes ago. Yeah. He likes Ocean Spray. Speaking of Tom, let's go back out and see what he's doing. Tom? There's the tail on Little Buck. Our camera crew will be going up. Adam Vance and Ruben Gallegos will be heading up with Carl Peterson, the pilot, and we'll try to talk to them as Little Buck goes up into the air.
There is hot air that goes into that little tail.
Right. All right, Tom, are you there?
We're here. We're here with Rod Baca and the Baca Pontiac balloon, and we're sort of right in the middle of the inflation process. He's down inside the basket, and he's turned on the propane burners. The fuel comes up from the tanks inside through this hose, and then it goes first through those coils at the top of the burner, puts it under tremendous pressure, so by the time it ignites here, it shoots a flame about 30 feet tall up inside the balloon. Now that you made that look easy.
Well, it was a night. We have a good crew.
You've been doing this a while, haven't you?
Well, counting today, it's 16 years.
Good for you. This is Rod Baca with Baca Pontiac. Now, we suspected that last weekend you got all the way down to the factory there in Berlin. Did you make it that far?
Well, yeah, we ran into a state trooper, and he pulled us over and clocked us about 90 miles and gave us a speeding ticket.
In the balloon. The ever-vigilant. So what's your flight plan for today?
Well, we're going to fly these two kids, Tom Stroba. He's our sales manager at Baca Pontiac, and it's sort of a payoff for him. And we're going to try and go south and box back north and maybe have a passenger change out.
And it looks like you'll be able to do that today with the wind the way it is. What's your name?
Jenny. Jenny Stroba.
Have you ever been in a balloon before?
No.
First ever balloon ride?
Yeah.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
And you?
I'm Janelle.
And have you done this before?
No.
Oh, hang on. Let me tell you one little secret. When he says, okay, we're going to land, you get in front, don't do it. You want to land on top of him, not the other way around, okay? We're here waiting for the liftoff of the Baca Pontiac balloon and watching one of the more skillful pilots of Balloon Fiesta, Rod Baca from Baca Pontiac down in Berlin. Out at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Of which you know a bunch.
He does. There goes Arabelle, the Creamland cow, taking to the air. One of the biggest balloons that you'll see out here. She is a big cow.
Every year. Good advertising medium for them. And can't go wrong.
They're usually one of the big sponsors out here each year.
I wonder if some year they can put a little sound effects with it too and have a little... horn going.
Yeah, you might be able to talk him into that. I mean, we made its debut probably 3 or 4 years ago, and they had a contest to name Arabelle. That's what they came up with. It's flown by Daniel Cave of Calgary, Canada.
I wonder if Arky is here this year. That's another one of my favorites.
You know, the Arky balloon is one of two balloons put out by Merit Ministries, and they brought the Jesus hot air balloon this year, so they may have left Arky at home and brought Jesus instead. But let's go to a break, and we'll be back with more of our live coverage out at Balloon Fiesta Park.
Oh, go away.
We are back out live at Balloon Fiesta Park, watching a lot of the special shapes take off this morning, and I've got a couple of guests with me. My kids are out here for the first time in a few years. You've been checking out the balloons, Waverly? What's been going on?
I've seen a
Mr. Buck is about to go off, but Miss Penny already went up.
Little Buck is about to go off, and Miss Penny already went up. Did you see her go up? There's the Jesus balloon. Which one did you like, Weston? The Energizer Bunny. You like the Energizer Bunny, huh? Did you get to get up close and see any of the balloons?
Yes, I did.
What did you see?
I like...
Which one did you get up close to?
We got up close to the hamburger balloon.
Ah. Was it pretty hot up there next to it?
Yes.
What was it like?
It was like the sun.
It was like the sun. Did you see the burner go...
Yes.
Yeah, and the fire come out?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Weston, what did you get up close to a balloon? No. You didn't want to get close to it, huh?
Yeah, I was afraid about the fire.
You're afraid of the fire. Well, that's probably smart to stay a little bit away from it. Huh? You see the Jesus balloon and the cow and Mommy, the Energizer Bunny?
You know what?
What?
I can't talk in the microphone.
Okay. Well, then I have to talk on the microphone, so let me talk for a few minutes and I'll talk to you again, okay?
I got to talk to you first.
All right. We want to tell you about the Chili Ristra, which is one of the big balloons. It's about to take off out here. I think there's something like 50 huge balloons ranging in size from 10 feet on up. And I think that made its debut about 2 years ago, the Chili Ristra did, representing New Mexico. Looks really neat when it's up in the air. Are you back? The maple leaf is about to take off. That is the Canadian Tourism Commission, and they are going to tell us more about Canada and try to convince us to go to Canada. They come every year, and they usually bring the mounted police balloon with them, but they couldn't this year.
Canada's a lovely country. I've visited several times, and even on this sabbatical that I am returning from, or from which I'm returning, my wife and I went to Niagara Falls, Canada, anyway. That was very, very nice.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, lovely, lovely. I saw kids are so special.
Thank you. They were giving me their perspective of being out on the balloon field. It's the first time that they've been out here in several years to see it. It's like coming out for the first time all over again.
That's what the joy of this balloon fiesta is seeing it through their eyes.
We're about to take off in Little Buck. Our camera crew is up there.
There he is, waving away.
Adam Vance and Ruben Gallegos up with Carl Peterson taking off in Little Buck, one of the two piggy bank balloons from Wells Fargo. I think they said each of those balloons is about 500 pounds worth of pig.
That's
a pretty
big
pig,
huh?
85 feet tall, 100 feet from nose to tail. Let's try to see if we can communicate with them. Carl Peterson is up in the balloon. Carl, can you hear us this morning?
I sure can, Diane.
Is it another great Mass Ascension day?
It's a beautiful day. It's the kind of day that we like to have.
Which way are you guys going to head out this morning?
We're going to go south for a little while and then go back up and try and come back over the field.
So the balloon, the box is working well?
It's working very well today.
All right. Have you been able to fly most, or you or the different pilots who fly the two pig balloons been able to get up most of the events this year?
Yeah, we've had a real good year, and obviously, you know, we lost a couple of days because of the wind. Otherwise, we've had a great year.
Right. The piggy banks, the Wells Fargo crew sponsors a lot of the special shapes events with Little Buck and Miss Penny, and the one on Thursday night was blown out, but you were able to do a glow last night, right?
Say again, Diana, I had to burn.
You were able to do the balloon glodio last night, and it turned out real well?
Couldn't have had a better glow. It was outstanding, had a great crowd. We hope everybody had a great time at our event.
All right, well, keep us posted on what it's like flying up there, and we'll check back with you later. Carl Peterson and our camera crew up in Little Buck this morning.
And you can have 1,000 launches, I'm told, and they all will be different. You can have 1,000 landings, and obviously they all can be different, and they all strive for safety, of course. I've looking around the skies this morning out of camera range. I see the Jesus balloon is up there as well this morning. That has drawn quite a lot of interest.
That's new this year,
in.
And it is a really big balloon. They tried to make it last year and didn't pass inspection at the very last minute and weren't able to get the balloon up, but it went up for the first time, I believe, last Sunday morning. And it's 258,000 cubic feet of hot air, 110 feet high,
100
feet wide, 65 feet deep. Wow.
775 pounds.
Yeah, that's
more
a
than.
Big balloon. It's a depiction of Jesus coming out of a cloud, and there are 12 international children surrounding him. And it is a co-balloon with Arki, which is Noah's Ark and all the little animals with it. Put on by the Merit Ministries. It's an outreach ministry from California.
And where is it, you ask? Well, it's up there somewhere, and trust me, it's up there. There's so many out there dotting the skies. All you need to do is look out your door if you live in the surrounding Albuquerque metropolitan area, and you will see that the Fiesta is in full force and soon to be in the history books.
As Rosalinda Roman was telling us, a lot of people don't want to fight the crowds. They don't want to fight the traffic, but they have found an ideal location right at I-25 and Alameda where they can get a really good viewpoint. Mm-hmm. And there's a fast food place nearby. They can grab some coffee and just sit there in their lawn chair. So people have, over the years, found out a lot of innovative ways to take advantage of seeing the Balloon Fiesta.
They'll come to join the fun from all parts of New Mexico.
We'll be back with more of our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park in just a moment. Just a moment. Stay around.
Welcome back. Caught me with my mouth full here. Danish. There's so much to eat. That's what makes it fun. I must gain a couple of 3 pounds here. But I can attest to the fact it is deliciosa comida. Good breakfast out here, no matter what it is. Good to be back on the airwaves here with Diane, and it's so much fun. I wouldn't miss this for the world. And I hope that if you've never been to the Balloon Fiesta Park, make plans for tomorrow, final day, or next year. We're going to go to Mike Sims right now. There seems to be an accident at the moment. Hopefully it's not too bad on power lines. Mike, can you tell us?
Yes, Nelson, we are high above the Sunset Memorial Park near the corner of Edith and Manal. That is in the northwest corner of the Big Eye in Albuquerque, where you can see an envelope folded over some power lines. You can see it's hung in the lines there, and rescue crews and I believe some kind of P&M power crew is on the ground. They're trying to untangle that balloon. You wouldn't imagine that in these kind of conditions that we would have an accident like this, but you know, a lot of these pilots are from out of town. We're not sure where this one is from, but these things do happen where they're trying to touch down. They're trying to find a safe place to land, and sometimes it just doesn't work out. In this case, we hope no one is seriously injured. We do see rescue crews on the ground again just to check out everyone. And they will spend the next few minutes trying to get this balloon untangled. But that's the latest from here. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Mike. And usually P&M is on the ball. They're standing by during this festival, the very busy festival where such things do happen. And they are quick to shut off power. If you are watching this on a portable television, that's what could have happened. So hopefully everything is okay there. That's quite dangerous. Let's check in with Diane, who is on the interview table, if you will, standing by with another guest.
Thanks, Nelson. I'm being threatened by a zebra. You know, the zebras, the officials out there that direct everybody, the launch directions every year. And last year I got striped. Did you ever get striped? The zebras just like give you this great big hug and they leave you with stripes all over your face. I'm being threatened. I'm going to watch out for the zebras. I have Bruce Puckett with me this morning, or Jeff Puckett this morning with me from iPix, and he has something very interesting to tell us about. When you check on the website for the International Balloon Fiesta, you see a dramatic 360-degree picture, and you guys are responsible for that.
Absolutely. iPix is here today to display their technology that we've created, which is completely immersive pictures, which allow anyone around the world on the internet to step inside the basket of one of these great balloons and go up in the air.
You've probably got to have not only the technology, but some pretty good skill in order to get a beautiful picture like that.
Well, like any good picture, you know, the photographer's eye really helps. But when you have content like this, it's hard to take a bad picture.
Now, when you go into the website, you can see one of the pictures or a couple of pictures from this year.
Absolutely. We've got about 5 photographers that are running around each and every day here at the Balloon Fiestival. And if you go on to balloonfiesta.com, you can check in the iPix photo gallery and click on different pictures from every day. Take you everywhere from inside the balloon to inside the basket to around the fairgrounds.
Tell us a little bit about how it actually works, how they are able to capture these
remarkable photos?
Well, the technology is very simple to use. Actually use a standard Kodak digital camera, and that's one of our partners here at the Balloon Fiesta. But you take a standard digital camera and you take two pictures. You take a picture in the front and you take a picture in the back. And our iPix technology software stitches those two pictures together so that you have the immersive environment so that you can look around, up and down and all around as if you were there.
Now, I know there are a great many amateur photographers out here. Is that kind of technology at all available to the public at this point?
Well, that's what we're here to find out. We wanted to show it to some consumers and to find out if the general public was interested in it. And so far, it seems like they're very excited by it.
I bet. And you're the balloon of the day.
We're the balloon of the day. It's our first time here at the Albuquerque Balloon Festival and are just excited to be here.
All right. Can anyone buy any of these photos? Do you have any of the photos available?
Absolutely. One of the things that we're doing is we've got an order form, and after the Balloon Festival's over, we're going to sell a CD-ROM that's going to have just hundreds of these 360-degree pictures on a CD-ROM for you to remember the event by.
So if you forgot your camera, you're not out of luck. Huh?
You're not out of luck.
Okay. Thank you very much, Jeff, for joining
us. BalloonFiesta.com.
All right.
Thanks.
All right. Let's check back now with Mike Sims and get the latest on that accident with the balloon and the power lines. Mike?
Well, Diane, we see rescue crews unloading a stretcher. We're hoping that no one is seriously injured in this, but you can see the paramedics there loading up their ambulance. A lot of people standing around, not sure how this happened yet, but we are on the corner of Edith and Manal. That's in the northwest corner of the Big Eye in Albuquerque. Again, a balloon envelope is completely folded over the power lines. They were supposedly coming in for a landing, got a little bit too close, and this is what happens. The balloon is upright, the balloon basket at least is upright, and the envelope is folded over the power lines on the very northern edge of the Sunset Memorial Park. And again, Albuquerque rescue crews are on scene. PNM is probably going to be showing up here in the next few moments to try to untangle this envelope. That's the latest. Back to you.
Thank you, Mike.
You know, we've been very fortunate over the past few years. We've had pretty much accident-free, or not too many accidents each year. This time we've had quite a few. We had a couple Monday, and I think one on Tuesday. But overall, it's still, when you think of how many balloons are in the air, a pretty safe event.
Close to 900. And yeah, no kidding. That's and today seems to be just beautiful, just absolutely beautiful.
All the balloons are up off the field now. There are none left. When you look out there, it's just a sea of people. But a lot of the balloons are heading over toward the Rio Grande and doing some splash and dash maneuvers this morning. And that's always something that's very exciting for the people on board to check out. Dip down, splash into the water, head back up, and you see the water dribbling down.
And that's such a precise little maneuver mm-hmm. that just allows the pilot to give enough gas to come down and then lift at a precise moment.
It shows the expertise and their talented. Skill. Let's go back out on the field where all that sea of people is and talk to Tom Rutherford.
Well, it's the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta, and the international part of it reflects the fact that balloons have come here from, I think, 23 nations and visitors from even more nations, and I'm speaking with some new friends of mine from the Netherlands.
What's your name?
Minnie Koster.
My name is Henk Koster.
And you have, I noticed you because you have the special shaped balloons sewn on your vest. The clown and the Santa Claus and the birthday cake. And have you come here with a balloon?
No, we work in the Barneveld Fiesta. It's in the Netherlands. And when they come over there, so we help them.
And did you come to help a particular balloon here?
Now we have helped with the Parasonic View and the famous footwear with Drew and Judy Rosnowski. And the first days we did, and now we are looking around.
And just having fun.
And just having fun.
You know, there's lots of things to see in New Mexico, not just balloons, but because the harvest is happening now, in all the little villages and at the pueblos nearby, there's lots to do. So I hope you get to spend time.
Not then. We're going back tomorrow.
All the way to the Netherlands?
All the way to the Netherlands.
When is the balloon race in the Netherlands?
Most time is in August.
In August?
Yes.
So we would find you there if we came in August?
We'll all be always there.
You'll always be there, yes. Helping the balloons.
Helping the balloons.
What's the weather like in the Netherlands?
Now it's raining, we heard, so it's not so good.
So it's good that you're here.
It's autumn and raining.
Okay. Well, here it doesn't rain in the autumn, usually. It's always beautiful like this. That's what we tell people who visit here. It is nice, isn't it?
Yes.
So these are our new friends from the Netherlands who are visiting at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Thank you, Tom. People everywhere out there right now. Of course, after you, after all the balloons go up, and they went up very quickly today, it's usually taken most of the 2 hours for the balloons to go up. But after all the balloons go up, then everybody heads over to the concession stands to do nothing more than eat and shop. We should say thank you to Mario's. We're right next to Mario's Pizzeria and Restaurante, and they take care of our crew every time in the early morning hours when they're getting ready and in the mid-morning hours when they're breaking down. Getting
Look
a really
people.
Interesting shot now from our cherry picker as it moves up, and you can see all those people out there. That's when the traffic jams, getting out to go do other things for the day.
It's the castle that seems so small, but indeed it is a huge thing.
Let's go to a break now. We'll be back with more. So join us again in a moment.
Welcome back. We're back at the final stretch here of Saturday's balloon ascensions, the last wave, and it's just a wonderful day out here in the balloon park. Sunshine is just as bright as can be. The air and the sky is clean and pretty as it always is in New Mexico. Da-da-dum.
Beautiful.
Thank you, Diane.
I have to tell you, you have a new fan.
Oh,
my daughter Waverly
this.
Just thinks you're the greatest.
Oh, I gave her a CD, and I want her to learn as many songs as she can from that because it'll lead you to be a huge mariachi singer someday.
Do you like that song?
Yes.
Oh, thank you,
Waverly. What do you like
Waverly?
About it?
I like when... I don't know.
You just like it all, huh?
Yeah.
Do you think he's a good singer?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
I think so.
Do you? Well, thank you. This is coming from an authority here.
Of course.
I know.
Yeah.
She knows a lot.
Well, I hope to hear you sing some of those with me someday, okay,
you
Waverly?
Sing with him sometime?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
Well, we're gonna go over and check out Smokey Bear. I think we've been upstaged by Smokey Bear over here. You want to go talk to Smokey Bear?
Yes.
All right. Let's do that.
All right. Let's see what kind of interviewee she is here. This is Diane's replacement someday, you know. Her lovely daughter, Waverly, and we're going over there as in a second to talk to Smokey Bear. There he is with Waverly and with Weston.
All right. Hi, Smokey. Ooh, I'm getting a hug, too. How about that?
And Waverly wants one, too.
Yeah, she's... Okay, well, we'll lift you up and give you a big hug. There we go. Oh, boy. So I guess you guys have been busy out there meeting all the kids this morning.
Yeah, we like to have Smokey come and watch the balloon take off, you know, every year, and we're just here having a good time.
Well, I saw the Smokey balloon go up. Everything looked fine.
Yeah, it was great. Great launch this morning. We had a good wind and weather, of course, and it was a good day.
You're Larry Heinman. You're representing the forestry division in the southwestern part of New Mexico?
Yeah, I work out of the regional office, the southwestern regional office here in Albuquerque.
All right.
And just volunteered to come and escort Smokey today.
You know, Smokey's been a part of this Balloon Fiesta for many years. I've seen him out there. And a lot of people say Smokey the Bear, but it's Smokey Bear, right?
Right.
Got it. That's right. And the original Smokey Bear was in the Lincoln National Forest
here
in New Mexico.
Right.
I remember that story as a kid. It's fascinated kids for years. But what's your purpose in having a balloon?
Actually, the balloon does not belong to the U.S. Forest Service. It's a private industry.
Mm-hmm.
They're in conjunction with the Forest Service, and we work with them to just promote the fire prevention message. And it's not a federal balloon. I mean, we do come... You know, and
work together on
it. Yeah, work together.
You know, the message of that Smokey has been able to get to kids nationwide for years, the prevention of forest fires, it's been a very effective tool.
Right. It's one of the most effective advertising campaigns that's ever been developed. It started back in the 40s or 50s or something like that, and it's been extremely successful.
All right. Yeah. Well, we appreciate your coming out here and joining us this morning. And have fun with all the kids out there on the ground, Smokey.
Great.
All right. See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
When I first came on board here a dozen years or so ago, I mentioned that Smokey the Bear would be on. And I was with Johnny Morse at the time. And he got so upset. He says, it's not Smokey the Bear. It's Smokey Bear. So, yes, sir. Stand corrected. It's Smokey Bear. Prevent forest fires. Well, that is so important. Don't litter, and especially that cigarette butt. Put it where it's supposed to go when you're traveling our beautiful, beautiful land of enchantment. We'll go to a break. Be back momentarily as we wind down the final weekend, just about.
All right, we are back live out at Balloon Fiesta Park, and there has been an accident this morning, a balloon that has gotten into some power lines near Edith and Manal. You've seen the shots from Sky 7, but we now have a crew on the ground. Tim Gutierrez is out there live. Tim, what can you tell us?
Well, Diane, this is Sunset Memorial Park. It's a cemetery here at Manal and Edith. The balloon is actually already packed up. These balloonists pack up very quickly. And it is already all balled up. It has a rip in it, and they're ready to load it. We can tell you what happened. It actually hit the power lines behind me. Public Service Company in New Mexico has just taken it down. We understand it was coming from the south, traveling south from the balloon park, when it actually hit into the Manal School and then bounced several times and ended up in those power lines. An elderly man was injured. He was taken to the hospital with some back injuries. Again, that balloon coming from Balloon Fiesta Park, coming south this way, hit one of the buildings at the Manal School and ended up in these power lines. It was taken down just minutes ago by Public Service Company of New Mexico. Again, they have already rolled it up, and everything appears to be okay other than that elderly man that does have back injuries. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Tim. We hope that's the only accident that we have to report this weekend, but we do have crews out and about, and that's one of the reasons we have so many people covering the Balloon Fiesta, is just in case there is some trouble. Nelson Martinez has a very beautiful guest now.
Mrs. New Mexico America, right here, ladies and gentlemen, Cheyenne Deppis.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, you know, I remember you 5 years ago or so.
That's exactly right.
Miss Albuquerque. I was privileged to interview you then, as I am now.
It was wonderful. We interviewed at this same spot.
Wow, how things change. The more they change, the more they stay the same, huh?
And how time flies. I was Cheyenne Ward then. I'm Cheyenne Deppis now.
Well, my. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
How are
much.
Things going?
Things are absolutely fabulous. It's been a great experience to meet Mrs. New Mexico and to meet all the wonderful people.
You've, you know, people associate this as being such a high privilege, which it is, but you also are very busy throughout schools and
a ton of hard work. That's exactly right. Sure. I make 1 to 2 appearances per week, so
are.
It keeps you busy.
And you talk to kids, and because they see you quite as a role model, there's a discipline that takes place here to be what you are.
That's exactly right. I do a lot more listening to kids than I do talking. I find that they create a better respect that way, and you can gain a lot more perspective.
And I guess the best thing that you can convey to any child that through the impressionable years is that any goal is attainable.
That's exactly right. Whatever you want to do, if you'd like to be a title holder like I am, or finish college, which is a great idea, kids, you can do it.
And it just takes a little discipline.
That's exactly right.
Discipline, that's no big deal, right?
That's exactly right.
You
remember
know
the last time we interviewed, I said, can I have your job? Because I always wanted to be a broadcast journalist, but you didn't give it up. So.
Well, listen, it still can happen. Remember, be careful for what you wish. You might get it.
I just might get it.
And you wish to be wearing this crown and look at you.
That's right. That's right.
Very nice, Miss Deppis.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank
again.
You so
nice
much.
To have you here.
It's wonderful to be here.
All right. Viva la fiesta.
That's right.
All right. Thanks, Nelson. All the balloons are up and about, and people are just everywhere out on the balloon field, but Joe Diaz is somewhere out there among them. Joe?
Oh, you know what? This is a special interview that we have right now, because with me is the number one balloon champion in the world, Bill Ayers. And you were telling me that to get that, you know, I go, well, how do you get to be the number one balloon champion in the world? You were telling me that you went to Austria, you borrowed a balloon, you competed in the competition. And how is it that you're even able to get to Austria? I mean, what does it take? How many people do they select to go and compete in this competition?
Well, it's the top 100 pilots in the world who are invited to compete in the championship. It's the Olympics of ballooning. So there's a long, drawn-out process. I started flying in 1986.
And that didn't seem like that long ago.
No, it's quite a while, though. When you look at 14 years to get to this point and to be the top pilot in the world in hot air ballooning.
Well, you said the top 100 went to compete. How many were from the U.S.?
Four from the U.S. There were four qualified pilots. So it's the top qualified pilots from each country who are invited to compete in each world championship. The world championship takes place every 2 years.
Now, you were telling me, like, we have competition during the week here where the pilots try to maneuver their balloons and drop on X's and sort of things like that. Is that how it's run over there?
Yeah, it's the same type of competition, just a higher level of competition. It's a lot more difficult. The tasks are more challenging. In one flight, we might have three or four different tasks where we have to maneuver the balloons as close as we can to the targets and then drop a marker, and the closest to the center of the X gets the highest number of points.
So you competed for a week, you got the most points, and you won.
And won the championship.
And here's the medal. Show me the medal.
Well, that's a medal presented by the FAI, the Fédération Aéronautique Internationale, and that's the governing body of all aviation activities.
Now, you were saying that we're going to show the trophy here. Tell me about this trophy.
Well, this is a traveling trophy. It goes from champion to champion every 2 years. It's called the Kinzinger Trophy, and it's a beautiful trophy made from bubinga, a tropical hardwood, and crystals from the California Gold Rush country and pewter. And it represents the pilot of the balloon coming into the, there's a target right here. That's the X he's going to maneuver the balloon into, just like in the championship.
Now, you're saying that people don't get to see this typically, right?
Well, regularly it stays in the champion's home for the 2 years, and then it gets passed on at the awards banquet.
So maybe this was the first time it was ever on TV?
as far as I know, well, not on television, but on public display in Albuquerque. As far as I know, it's the first time it's been displayed. People are excited about seeing it.
Okay, let me show you something here. If you happen to pick up the Ballooning Magazine, the current, there he is, there's Bill Ayers, the number one balloon champion in the world right there. And what are you doing out here for the Fiesta? I guess you're not flying though, are you?
No, I didn't plan to come here, so I'm not a registered pilot. I had not planned to come, and after winning the championship, I thought I'd come and to put the trophy on display, and I'd also carried some commemorative envelopes during the championship, and I'm selling them in the balloon mail tent, the official balloon mail tent next to the post office.
Okay.
On the field.
So you can come to the concession stand, you can go to the balloon mail tent over here, and you can meet Bill Ayers, the number one balloon pilot in the world. Back to you guys.
All right, Joe. Thank you, Joe. All the balloons have lifted off. They're starting to set down in different places around Albuquerque. A few of them have come back to the field to land, and that's one of the big advantages of having this new field that we've been at it for the last 4 years or so, is to allow them to come right back and land right where they took off, especially the special shapes. That works great for them.
Sure does. Well, we'll just about say goodbye to you in a few minutes. Let's just take a breather break here and be right back on this Saturday morning, and it's good to be here.
We are back live out of Balloon Fiesta Park. A lot of people stopping by to say hello to us as they head on their way back out to fight the traffic and get back out and go check out some other things that are going on. You know, this isn't the last balloon event, of course. This afternoon, this evening, my Magic Glow, they say it starts at 5:30, but it really won't get underway until dusk.
Yeah.
That's when you can really see the balloons glow.
Look at that cute little baby.
Yeah,
or
they'll be back out here.
Should I call it a baby? Well,
yeah. They'll be back out tonight. And then right after the Night Magic Glow tonight, there'll be a fireworks show about 8, 8:30 or so.
That's always nice.
Mm-hmm. We watched it the other night from up on Alameda and I-25. Just stopped. We happened to be going by and just stopped and let the kids see the fireworks show.
Last night over the Duke Stadium. That was fabulous.
Mm-hmm. And
so
then
much
tomorrow
activity.
Morning is the final Mass Ascension. The Dawn Patrol show, they've choreographed it all into a little show, thanks to our Craig Kennedy and David Breidenbach and a few other people, and they will take off at 5:30. It's something to see. This morning, some of the special shapes went up in the Dawn Patrol, and that's really neat. And then it'll be followed by the Mass Ascension at 7 tomorrow morning.
Also, an activity that's been going on for years, 9th season, I believe, down in Truth or Consequences, Geronimo Days. Hope you can take a drive down there to Truth or Consequences, Tier C, for Geronimo Days. I'm going to join them down there with a mariachi group live and at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Can't miss it. It's in the county fair area where they have their county fair. And hope to see you all there. It's really a nice event every year. This is my 8th year, I believe, down there. And it's always nice to be feel so welcome.
Busy day for you today, huh?
Pardon me?
Busy day
for
you.
Busy day, yeah. We'll go down there, and I'll even be there this evening, and so I hope to get back here by midnight, and then...
You better be back on the job tomorrow morning.
Sleepy-eyed, but hey, one of these days we'll have to take you down there with us, because people ask about you all the time, Diane.
Well, that's really nice.
To your seat. Good people.
I'll travel along as you don't make me sing.
I bet you'd surprise all of us.
Surprise for the worst, but anyway.
I doubt it.
Splash and Dash, we saw just a moment ago, some beautiful shots now from our Sky 7 cam, and a lot of different angles we're showing you as the balloons start to head back to take a, I think that's from our bluff cam actually. See, we have so many cameras, we don't even know which
one's
which.
Hard to keep track.
But a lot of them are coming back to the balloon field to sit down, and others will be, we had some sit down in our yard.
Did you really?
We lived in Corrales a few years ago, and that was really neat. It's exciting to watch it. And then it's such interesting how those crews just bundle all that back up and get it put together. But the chase crews are such an important part of ballooning, and we don't really recognize them that much. They're the ones who do all the work,
yep,
while everybody else is having fun up in the balloons.
That's true.
And kind of the same way with our crew here. They do all the work, and you and I come in and talk for a couple of hours and take
true.
off, and then they have to do a bunch more work.
They do the work. Okay.
You know, some other volunteers who really aren't recognized are those parking guys every year. What would we do without the parking people around here? It'd be a chaos.
You know, if it weren't for the volunteers for this Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta, they'd be in big trouble, because
right.
They are the ones that put it all together and show the hospitality to our out-of-towners.
Mm-hmm.
And incidentally, the RV parks around here sold out. And
wow.
There are literally thousands of RVs in town. Welcome, y'all.
people
and
everywhere.
Keep on coming back.
We want to thank you for tuning in this morning. If you watched from your couch at home, and join us again tomorrow morning. We'll be back with more of our live coverage starting at 7 tomorrow morning.
And I'll see you in Truth or Consequences, 2 o'clock, Mariachi Los Galleros. I'm looking forward to it. See you tomorrow morning here,
bye
too.
Bye-bye.
You've been watching live coverage of the 1999 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascension.